What's going on, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and fellow YouTubers, all of you, I bid welcome to this aesthetic review about the new lockbox ships from the Sphere Builders, the Denuos Dreadnought Carrier, and that is a tier 6 ship. Very excited to do this ship. As you guys know, or probably know, I really love and enjoy flying carriers. Those are like my favorite ships out there. And, you know, when Star Trek actually released the information of all of these Sphere Builder ships, I was so excited. And now it's finally here and I got one. And I'm going to showcase that with all of the visuals right here. Now, what I normally do, I tend to have around 200 master keys that I want to spend using, you know, for any particular ship that I want to obtain in Star Trek Online. But if I don't have that, if I don't get it, I just grab it off the exchange. And that is what I did for this ship. I didn't actually spend my master keys, so I thought to myself, let's be absolutely sure that I'm going to get this one, and I got it from the exchange. It is currently priced at 340 million EC. So if you want to obtain this ship, it is available through two different ways: by opening lockbox keys with masteries, with master keys, lockbox ships with master keys. And if you're not that lucky, but you're really a high roller in STO, you can obtain one from the exchange. Or maybe, and that's just maybe, you might have one, a giveaway. You might actually win a giveaway that I'm currently going to do on Saturday. I hope you guys are going to be there, because I'm going to give away lots and lots of items. You can find the link in the video description to actually showcase where the or when these giveaways are going to take place. But anyway, as I already have purchased mine, it is currently my current Starship. I actually don't have the option to tell you guys all of the statistics. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the official Star Trek Online web page, and I'm going to grab all of the information from there. So just a little bit of information, what is up and what you guys are going to see. First of all, I'm going to go through all of the information, what this ship has to offer. After that, I'm going to try to customize the Starship a little bit and showcase what customization can be done to this ship, if any. And after that, we're going to go into space, because in space, that is where I'm going to equip all of the different space sets, where it's going to change the ship's appearance. And that is why you guys are here. You want to see the ship in changing its appearances. That's awesome. And also after that, we're going to take a little bit of a tour of the Starship bridge. Hopefully we're going to get a unique bridge with this ship. After that, we are going to showcase the masteries, the bridge officer slots and stations. And after that, as a final, we are going to take this ship into combat and we're going to do our Gala Patrol. But first of all, let's go through the statistics. Now, I have, like I said, I kind of need to be on Star Trek Online Arc game. So that's the official Star Trek. And this is the ship that we're going to do the review about. So the Sphere Builders Denuos Dreadnought Carrier, and that is a tier 6. So here we go with the information right here. Like many vessels built for temporal conflicts, the Denuos is equipped with a molecular reconstruction systems, giving it a wide number of tactical options in battle. It also features a Chroniton Fragmentation Warhead Launcher, a devastating weapon system of Sphere Builder's design. Awesome. And if you guys don't know how to pronounce this thing, I really didn't know as well. So I'm going to let my computer take a shot at it.
Denuos.
Denuos. She said Denuos. Let's see it. Let's hear it again.
Denuos.
Denuos. Okay, so that's how I'm going to pronounce it from now on. This starship features a commander tactical slash temporal operative bridge officer seat and a lieutenant engineering slash command bridge officer seat. Temporal ships are capable of making subtle alteration in the molecular of the on the molecular level through the use of molecular reconstruction. This technology allows the starship to consume one of three different configurations. Defense, offense, or support. Each configuration has its own strength and weaknesses. Each of these configurations generates their own specific counter. Up to six counters can be generated at a time. These counters are used to fuel your molecular deconstruction beam. Real nice and real. I've seen this thing take entire starship apart and really awesome. If you guys are using any of the tier 6 that have come as of late on Star Trek Online, this is basically what you're going to get. Now, I'm not going to read through this because for all of the ship, it's the same. And I'm just going to skip that. Hopefully, you're not going to hate me for that too much. Anyway, the Sphere Builder Denuos Dreadnought Carrier Tier 6 has a pair of hangar bays equipped with the Sphere Builder Heavy Fighters. These durable small craft are equipped with the Anti-Proton Beam Array, Chroniton Torpedoes, and Beam Overload 1, and Channel Deconstruction 1 abilities. Now, in all of my experience in Star Trek Online, none of the pets that I currently own, and I own a lot of pets because, as you guys know, and you know, I just said so in the previous section of this video, I love having pets. None of them have channel deconstruction abilities like these guys are going to have. So with these guys, when they're going to fire this option, this channel deconstruction abilities skills, they're going to take care of enemies even faster. You know, their hit points are going to be diminished in a really fast pace. But anyway, so here are the ship details, here are the ship statistics. So it is available to all factions, Federation, Klingons, Romulans, all of them are available for you to obtain this ship. So it is only available through the Sphere Builder lockbox. So that is the lockbox you need to open with your mastery keys to obtain this thing. It is a tier 6, required rank Rear Admiral, Sub Admiral 1, or Brigadier General. A hull strength of 42,000 hit points, 750 at level 40. 49,162 hit points at level 50. And also 57,000 hit points at level 60, and that is awesome. A shield modifier of 1.15, really awesome for a carrier. Four weapons on the front, three weapons on the aft, three device slots. That is what we are accustomed to in carriers, when we're flying carriers. The bridge officer stations and seating I'm going to skip because I'm going to showcase this in a later stage of the video, so stay tuned for that. A console modification of 4 tactical, 3 engineering, and 4 science. And as you guys know, science abilities rock these days. A base turn rate of 8 degrees per second, impulse modifier of 0.15, and inertia rating of 0.35. Plus 10 to weapon power and also plus 10 to shield power, really awesome. It also comes equipped with that universal console, so the Chroniton Fragmentation Warhead Launcher that we're going to showcase in the space combat portion of this video, and that is going to be awesome. molecular reconstruction, we already know that. So subsystem targeting, real awesome. Two hangar bays equipped with the Sphere Builder fighters. Also the mastery package, a tactical carrier, so we're going to get a tactical pet recharge time reduction, a armored hull that is going to increase the hit points of our ship, enhanced weapon system that is going to increase the damage that we are going to do from our weapons, and also advanced shield system that is going to increase the maximum shield hit points of this thing, and also the Delphic Shockwave, and that is a starship trait. This thing is really awesome. Now, this Starship Trait, where is it? Because it's a little bit down up here. Now, these are like the other ships that I'm also going to do a review about. But that Universal Console, let's read a little bit about that. Or, you know what? I'm going to skip this one. I'm going to showcase that in a later stage. So here's the Starship Trait. So that is the Delphic Shockwave. After achieving level 5 in your sphere, Builder Denuos Dreadnought Carrier, you will unlock the Delphic Shockwave Starship Trait. While this trait is slotted, your Photonic Shockwave Science Bridge Officer ability will leave behind a localized anomaly that mimics the effect of the Delphic Expanse.
What?
Am I reading this right? It's awesome. Enemies that enter this hazard will suffer radiation damage over time and have their damage resistance reduced. What? This is awesome. Also, these hangar pets, these are the heavy fighters. We're not going to get those. We are going to get... wait a minute, what were we going to get? And I'm just scrolling up right now. Not that one, not this one. This is the carrier. So which pet were we going to get? The Sphere Builder Fighters. Sphere Builder Fighters, okay. These are the heavy fighters. Heavy fighters as well. These are the other ones. Okay, that's weird. Anyway, I'm going to showcase these fighters in here, because what I actually did, I actually went to my fleet starbase and I actually purchased the elite version of these normal fighters that we currently have equipped. And just to showcase the difference between them, these normal ones that come equipped, like when you unlock or when you actually purchase this ship or when you win this ship, by giveaways or whatever, or you know, opening lockbox with mastery keys, you're going to get these guys. These guys are like the normal version. So these guys have forward anti-proton arrays, chroniton torpedo on the front, and on the aft they're going to have anti-proton array, beam overload 1 as an ability, and also that channel deconstruction 1. And there is also so these guys are the cheapest one, and these are like the elite one, the most expensive one, but there's also one that you can obtain through the dilithium store. And as you guys are seeing, there is this button up here, the dilithium store, that I just opened up. You go here to hangar pets, you scroll all the way down, and then you see these guys. Obviously, these guys have just a better version of beam overload, and that's actually it. I also have torpedo high yield 1. So that's the main difference between the standard version that you get on this thing. You don't have torpedo high yield, you have beam overload 1. The dilithium version from the dilithium store has beam overload 2 and also torpedo high yield 1. And the one from the fleet starbase has beam overload 2 and also torpedo high yield 2. And that's basically it for these pets. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put 2 of my elite version and I'm going to discard these guys, because these guys are yucky. And you can obviously obtain them again if you want to. So this is how the ship looks like. We already did the information, but let's go through it again. So we're going to have 4 weapons on the front: deflector, impulse, warp, and shield. Those are basically normal. 3 weapons on the aft, 3 device slots, 3 consoles for the engineering, 4 for the science, and also 4 for the tactical slots. So that is awesome. Now let's go to this NPC right here and see how much we can customize. She looks really cool. The starship. And I kind of need to pay attention what I'm doing, not to enjoy the scenery. Sorry about that. So here is the ship as it is when it comes out of the box. Really awesome. Really, really excited to do this thing because it looks really amazing. And I have it upside down. But anyway, here's how it looks like. Really awesome to see this really big sphere in you know, in the center of the ship. This upper strut is really awesome, kind of like reminds me of, no idea what it reminds me actually. And this bottom part is really awesome as well. It's basically holding these two struts up here together with this sphere. Oh, there's another one. Okay. Hold on. There's another sphere up here. This guy, wow. You guys didn't say that to me. There's another one. And this thing is actually, it's pulsating. It's pulsating with the interior of this thing. Wow. That is just amazing. That is cool. I love seeing these kind of stuff. Does it pulsate all over? Yes, it does. Look at this. Look at it right here. It is pulsating. Nice. Nice. I love that. I love that. Anyway, obviously one kind of template, nothing else there. We do have an interior, so we're going to showcase this unique bridge. That is awesome. We only have one window type. So these are these blue windows up here. There isn't any other window types that I can see anywhere else. This ship is like upside down. There it goes. That's better. yeah, this is just the normal version. Material type. We only have one material type, and I'm not even going to try to pronounce that. Tutarian type. Tutarian type one. Let's see, advanced, we have the main sphere. I guess that is this big one up here. You can obviously change the pattern on top of this thing and make it look like that, where you can actually change the colors to whatever is going to be to your liking. And I'm just going to change this one just to have like a bright color so you guys can actually see what the difference is going to be. There is another sphere. I guess that's the second one. This one on top. Orion as well. Oh, look at that. It's a really bright red ball. Awesome. Back hole. Let's see where that is. Oh, it's just this thing underneath up here. And I know I am just making this ship look really bad. To apologize. The main hull. Okay, now it looks like a clown, but you guys understand what I'm going through with this thing. There is also an inner ring, I guess, from the sphere, because it has like these red lines going through that thing. Okay, an outer ring one. This part right here, does it has, okay, so all of the rings has that except this one, and I guess that's ring number two. Yeah, so that's ring number one, that's ring number two, so you can actually see a little bit of color on this thing. Now obviously I am going to cancel all of the changes because I really don't want to be flying that thing. I'm canceling all of the changes because I want actually to represent the ship what it is, how it looks like when coming out of the box, and don't really want to represent something else. Anyway, right now let's head into space, because we are at that point where you can actually are going to equip all of the different space sets on this ship, and when we're going to witness how this ship is going to transform in its configuration or its in its appearance, the way it is going to change, and that's going to be awesome. Come on, move. Where is my evasive maneuvers? There you go. It turns really good when you have evasive maneuvers on. I don't know how it's going to perform when it's not using evasive maneuvers, because to be honestly, carriers do not turn real good. Carriers tend to be like a support ship. They don't do a lot of DPS. They're not here to actually kill the enemy, but they're more like, you know, to support. But this is how the ship looks like when it's, you know, with the normal default skin type with nothing equipped on the That is going to change the way the ship appears. Let's see what we can get. Okay, so the fighter pets go left and right. So we're going to go left and right again. Okay, that's cool. And where are the pets? Maybe we can have like a closer look on these guys. There we go. There's one. Can we get a closer look on this guy? A little bit zoom in. There we go. That's... Oh. So these are the pets that we're going to use. Kind of looks like a horseshoe with like a big ball in the center of it. That's nice. I like that. So all of these pets are going to be the same. And let me remove the HUD. There you guys go. Yeah, so it's kind of like a horseshoe kind of type deal. Nice. So there's always a lucky charm on you. Oh, that's awesome. Anyway, let me just remove these guys because they're going to be annoying, to say the least. And let's try to equip some different visuals on this ship. Because it's going to be amazing. Or at least I hope it's going to be amazing. Can't wait anyway. Here we go. The first space set that we are going to equip is going to be the Mako space set. Mako. Do we have all three pieces of the same one? We do. Now let me also discard these guys because they are just going to make my inventory full. And this is how it looks like with the Mako space set. Wow, look at this. I love these, I don't know what to call them, rivets, I guess. It's kind of like brick and mortar between them. Oh, that is sick. And this is how much this ship is actually banking, because I'm at full imports right now. Oh, this sphere. Oh my god. I love the colors on this upper sphere part. Wow. The way this thing is looking right now, it kind of reminds me of the movie Sphere with Sharon Stone. I don't know if you guys know that. And wow, that is the first thought that came in my brain right now. This sphere looks exactly like that other sphere in the movie. Wow, I love this thing. This thing looks amazing. Okay, here we go. Deflector dish. I was wondering where they're going to put the deflector. So the deflector dish is right up here. And we have like the impulse engines coming out of there. That is awesome. Right in the middle of this strut. Nice. I also see these patterns up here and also within the sphere. Now, I don't know if this sphere is going to rotate anytime soon or anything like that. Also, don't really know where the weapon nodes are going to be, because that is going to be awesome to see. Oh, we do have a little bit of clipping issues right here. These patterns are not matching up correctly. Maybe you guys can do a little bit of better work, Cryptic. These things aren't matching up correctly right here. But it is awesome to look at. Love it. Love it. All right, let's move on. The Aegis space set is next. Hopefully I'm going to have enough room for all of the space sets out here. All three pieces of the Aegis space set. Look at this. What? Wow. Love the engine output and the engine animation that you guys are seeing. On the Federation you guys are seeing right now, you have these whitish, bluish glow. And on the Klingon side, you have the same type of glow, but only with the red color instead of the blue one. And that makes it worthwhile. Definitely loving this part. Subtle changes. That is making this ship look amazing. Look at this, that is awesome. This thing is still pulsating with the background right there. Nice! And as you guys are seeing these subtle rings up here, they have like this whitish outline to them. Nice, nice! I like it! So that's the Aegis space set. Oh, the Borg space set. Okay, so let's put a Borg Universal Console. Where is that? Here we go. And this is how it looks like with the Borg Universal Console. The deflector dish, the nodes up here. Awesome! So we have a sphere that is being assimilated for the Borg. Nice! Oh, that is sick. This thing is really insane. I do wish that this thing would rotate. But I guess that's too much. Ooh, nice, nice. Look at these nodes up here. 1, 2, 3. Where's the fourth one? Anywhere up here? No. There's one up there. There's a 2, 3. And there should be another one somewhere. But I am not seeing that. Loving the Borg space set on this thing. This thing is crazy. Can actually see a little bit of Borg color up here in the front of this thing. Nice. Which one is next? The Counter Command space set. That's the wrong one. Counter command. There we go. Counter. Oh my god. Are you for real? Wow, this thing is taking my breath away. God damn it. What? Oh, we still have the Universal Console from the Borg. Let me just remove that. Go away. Wow, look at this. Wow, I'm speechless right now. I'm sorry, guys. I love this thing. It looks amazing. Look at this. This is awesome. That reflection. Wow. Universal, or the deflector dish, that nice animation right there from the engines. And the sphere also changed in its entirety. I mean, look at these things. These colors are awesome. Wow. Okay, next. Hurry. which one is the Delta? Here we go with the Delta space set. Delta and Delta shields. We have all three pieces. We do all three pieces of the Delta. Ooh, look at this. What is this? I never saw this as an emblem or mark or whatever it's called. Like two snakes. Nice. It's on here as well. Nice. See, this is why you need to equip all of the different visuals. Because you're just, you know, you're finding out stuff. Now, I don't think this is part of the the space set. I think this is part of the ship, but it wasn't really clear until we equipped the Delta space set. And as you guys are seeing, the Delta space set has some really cool features, but mostly it's like grayed out all over the place. No, really, you know, can't really be. Can't really love the Delta space set, in all honesty. But I definitely love these. Like, I have no idea. Is this like the icon or the emblem from the sphere builders? Is this their icon? like a leaf and like an ape or something like that, that is, has like two big arms, or are they like represented by a snake or something like that? I have no idea. Not really my favorite, the Delta space set, but that's just my personal choice. Here we go with the Dyson one, and this is definitely going to be awesome. Dyson engines and Dyson shields. Oh my god, look at this. Oh wow, this is definitely awesome. Oh wow, 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 wow. Look at this. This is definitely awesome. This sphere right here with all of these purple lines going through, that is just amazing. Look at that. Also, this, somebody's PMing me right now. Sorry if the long was okay. I'm just looking around. I'm not sure if I told you I was selling. Oh. Oh, this is awesome. I love the colors that they have. These brownish with the white and like the pink lines are going through. Wow, these are awesome. Nice deflector dish animation. Wow, this ship is awesome. God damn it. Oh man, you guys are doing such a good job, Cryptic. Here we go with the Iconian space set. Iconian engines and shields. 1, 2, 3. Here we go. Look at this. This is the Iconian space set with all of the visuals. I love it. I don't like this part right here because it's like just a little bit too much, but I definitely love the big sphere up here. That is just amazing. Look at this. And these guys are like, you know, that pulsating stone. That is just awesome. This is, oh man, this looks amazing, man. Look at this. This is awesome. Man. Iconian space set is really kicking butt. Is Jem'Hadar next? 1, 2, 3. Oh wow. What, man, this is I'm gonna say something really bad. I hope I don't offend anybody, but this part right here kind of reminds me when you have like a really bad rash or something like that and you're like scratching all over the place. This part right here reminds me of that. That you scratch your skin so much that it turned like purple or pink. And it's almost ready to, you know, to blood to come out. And I know I'm being real gross right now, but it kind of reminds me of that. But it looks amazing though. Just beside of that. No, I'm just not doing this ship really, really, really good by saying that. But, you know, honestly, it looks really good. Look at this. I love that they actually added a little bit of color so you guys can actually see some more details up here underneath these two struts up there. Awesome. Now with the Jem'Hadar space set, these upper sphere are not pulsating anymore. I guess that's by design. And the inner sphere, or the big sphere right there, kind of looks like the other sphere that actually started like firing on planet Earth in the Enterprise episodes. Nice. Looks really good, except for the rash. Oh man, I hope you guys are not going to be commenting about this part, or at least not a lot. Okay, I'm going to skip the Kobali space set because it doesn't offer any visual changes to the ship at all. The Mako, we already did with the adaptive Mako, so no changes to the ship. To the ship's visual, these are just the same. Which one is this? The Nukara does offer a variety of changes to the ship's appearance, so we're going to definitely use these guys. 1, 2, 3. And this is how it looks like with the Nukara space set. Oh, wow. Loving the upper sphere. This is awesome. Nice engine output. Really cool deflector dish animation that you guys are seeing. Wow. Really love this part right here. Wow. That is, oh, that is so bright up here. These two, like, I don't know, inner spheres, I guess, that are holding the outer sphere in place. Oh, that is just sick. Oh, this thing is definitely a good purchase on my part. Wasted a little bit of money or EC, but as it is visually, oh my god, I'm loving it. I'm definitely liking this ship. Nice. On the outside, it looks really, really good. Can't wait to see the bridge, though. Let's see. Mako, we did new. The Omega Force. This is going to be awesome. Going to have a little bit of changes to this thing. Okay, we got the three-piece set. Here we go with the Omega. Nice. More like sphere builder layout. You guys can see a little bit more of details. Definitely love these square pattern up here. Nice. We got that pulsating thing again coming back with totally different lines that I'm seeing right here. So it has like the little bit of armament going up this sphere right here, as you guys can see, and looks good. Like, even the windows are, have, you know, a little bit of armament to that. Really cool deflector dish animation like that. I definitely like that. And these squares kind of reminds me of, like armaments that have been ripped apart and need a little bit of a overhaul. So you kind of need to go back to a shipyard to actually get repaired. We already did that. The quantum phase, no visual changes there, so I'm going to skip that one, but the Riemann does have some awesome visuals, and that is definitely one that I'm going to show you guys. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. Oh my god! What? Oh man. Okay, this is how this ship is going to be flown from me. This thing looks amazing. Wow. This is sick. Wow. Definitely love the new glow and pattern and lightning and graphics that they're adding to the game. Wow, I am absolutely speechless right now. This, if you guys actually see my face right now, wow. I'm like smiling from ear to ear. This thing looks amazing. Look at this. Wow. Wow. What is this? What is this? Why didn't they add anything to this upper sphere part? Oh, that's a big disappointment right here. I love that if they had like these kind of patterns that you guys actually see lines and stuff like that going through this upper part as well. Oh, there's a little bit of disappointment, but it's still good. It's still good. I love it. I still love it. It's awesome. And as you guys can actually see up here on the sides of this ship, we still have like this monkey or whatever it is. I think it's like a logo from the Sphere Builders. I think this is how they're going to be represented in the game. Nice. Some really cool details. Loving it. Okay, let's do the Romulan one after the Reman. We are always going to do the Romulan version. 1, 2, 3. Okay, just enough. Just to make a difference. Nice. Oh, that inner sphere part. Oh, man, those lines. Loving it, those lines. So you have just a little bit of greenish glow or greenish line coming through this ship. Just enough. Not too much to be overwhelming like the Riemann space set that we just saw. But you kind of have like this distinguishment of whatever shielding type you are going to be equipped it for visuals. And you kind of see that this thing has definitely Romulan all over the place. Nice. Quantum phase, no visuals. Skip. Soul defense, no visual. We're going to skip that one. The Solanae. Let's try the Solanae. I don't think that has visuals. But it's been a while that I actually did a ship review. So let's see. No visuals up here. No visual changes. So we are going to do the next best thing. And yeah, let's do the temporal defense. The disco, the disco space, that is, you guys are calling it. No, what is this? This is the Terran one. That one. 1, 2, 3 pieces. Here we go with the disco space set. This is awesome. Oh man, this is so funny. Oh man, it looks really good, but it kind of looks funny at the same time. Oh wow. Definitely love these patterns that you guys are seeing up here. This is kind of like it's dried out dirt in the Sahara or something like that. Has a little bit of all colors going through them. Wow, it looks good. It kind of grows on you the more that you look at this thing, though. The more time you're going to spend flying this ship in this visual configuration, I guess it's going to be more appealing to you, I guess. Love that they actually put up like this inner where the sphere is actually holding these two mechanisms up here, that they're actually emitting different lights. Love that. Even the outer sphere or the dome shaped thing on top is really awesome. Cool, really cool. Okay, let's move on to the Terran space set. The one we just equipped the engines from. Soul defense Terran. We do have all three pieces of the Terran space set. Wow, this is amazing. What? Oh wow, these pink colors, these are just amazing. Nice. Wow. This ship looks amazing. Look at this. This brownish color with that, you know, little bit of a light brown color with that darkened brown red stripes, a little bit of pinkish glow on top of this sphere. Real cool animation from the engines. Live, love that. Really cool deflector dish animation. And we have, like, I don't know what these are. Pinkish outlines, but I really love it. I love this thing. It's awesome. Damn it. Okay. We don't have any different visual space sets except the green one, and that is going to be the last one because we are running out of all of the visuals or the space set that we have equipped. So this is going to be the last one. The Breen space sets with Breen space visuals. Wow. Wow. This is awesome. I love this sphere, man. Look at this. Definitely changed the configuration of this ship, or at least the visuals. Oh, man. Kind of reminds me, this part right here, this dome shape thing, doesn't like remind you guys of I don't know what it is called, like turrets on a plane that was actually firing at the enemy, like World War II planes. They actually had a guy up here that were not like, you know, firing shots out of. With two big guns or four big guns, I don't know, but it kind of reminds me of that. But this ship is definitely growing on me, and it is really awesome. This is going to be my new favorite ship, man. Wow. I hate not using the Iconian carrier, but I think this is going to be my new favorite ship. This thing is really awesome. And I'm going to equip the Riemann space set. That's going to be my favorite space set for the visuals. Now, as you guys know, there is a visual tab right here, so you can have like a totally different deflector impulse or shielding type to use for the ship statistics, and have a totally different one for the visuals. So keep that in mind if you wanna, you know. You could obviously do it the way I'm doing it, but I would definitely recommend you guys using like the normal deflector impulse and shield up here just for the visuals in the visual tabs, and have totally different statistics for this ship. But this is definitely my favorite visual set right here. Wow, this and the Dyson one. The Dyson is like the favorite space set for all of the shieldings, but this one is really awesome, especially these glow up here. That is just crazy. Starship Masteries, we did not cover this one, or at least not the numbers. So quit deployment, that is Starship Mastery level 1, is going to be 36.5% recharge time reduction to launching carrier hangar pets crafts. Plus 50% rank up for... No, that is just a trait that I have. I'm not going to read about that. Level 2, armored hull, increasing your hull hit points by 10%. Level 3 is going to increase your kinetic damage and all energy damage by 10%. Level 4, plus 10% shield hit points. And a level 5, that is that Delphic Shockwave. So, removes the repel effect from your photonic shockwave ability. Now, hopefully, I'm going to have one of those. And if I'm not, I'm going to grab one from the NPC. Using photonic shockwave leaves behind a level 61 Delphic expands anomaly. So, two foe is going to get 719.6 radiation damage. That's going to ignore the shield every 0.5 seconds for 5 seconds, up to 5 foes in a 3-kilometer radius. So let's simplify that. Every 1 second, you're going to get about 14,000 radiation damage to your foe. So double 719. So about 14,000 radiation damage for the duration of 5 seconds. So if you have your enemy up there, like, I don't know, like gravity well, and then a photonic shockwave, you're basically are going to take Let's see, 5 times 14, about 7,000-ish, 8,000. If you can hold your enemy there for 5 seconds, radiation damage. Wow, that's a lot. That is a lot. Anyway, those were the masteries. The Universal Console information. Let's read a little bit about this. The Sphere Builder Denuos Dreadnought Carrier comes equipped with the Chroniton Fragmentation Warhead Launcher. When this ability is active, your starship will launch a projectile that will detonate in a large area of effect shortly before hitting your target. Wow! Foes hit by this explosion will be bombarded with Chroniton Warhead Fragments, which will cause heavy kinetic damage and have their turn rate and flight speed dramatically reduced. After a short cooldown, these fragments will explode in an area of effect, inflicting shield penetration, heavy kinetic damage. This explosion also knocks a random subsystem offline. Nice. This is awesome. So we're going to have an explosion that's going to knock down a subsystem offline. That could be, I guess this is going to be a random subsystem. So that could be like weapons, shields, engines, or auxiliary power from your enemy. So that's always nice, right? To have your enemy without shields or engines or weapons. Awesome. So when you're going to equip this thing, it's going to give you plus 1% critical chance and also plus 15% in flight turn rate. That's really awesome for carriers that, you know, tend not to turn real quick. Okay, when this ability is activated, we just read that. Target foe, so 180 degree targeting arc, 1.5 to 10 kilometer range, so you cannot activate this thing in short range. So your enemy need to be about 1.5 kilometer away from you. Okay, this is new. 2 minute recharge launches a level 61 fragmenting Chroniton warhead. So to foe, 6,619.5 kinetic damage up to 5 foes within 3 kilometer radius. Significantly reduces flight speed and turn rate for 12.8 seconds up to 5 foes in a 3 kilometer radius. After 6 second countdown, foe is going to get 13,238.9 kinetic damage with 100% shield penetration. What the heck, man? Oh my god. So initially you're going to get like 6,600 kinetic damage, and after 6 second cooldown you're going to get 13,000. So basically 20,000 kinetic damage with 100% shield penetration. Also, a subsystem knock offline for 3.6 seconds. Wow, this ability is going to be killer. Wow. Wow, this is awesome. 2.5% chance of 503 physical damage every 1 second for 10 seconds. That equals to 5,000 physical damage if you can hold your enemy with 10% chance. 10% chance with projectiles. Don't really know what this means. 10% chance with projectiles. So you're going to use torpedoes while you're going to use this thing? That's weird. 2.5% chance physical damage every 1 second for 10 seconds. 10% chance with projectiles. Anyway, moving on. So this is also part of a space set. These two Delphic particle accelerator. If you have the two universal consoles, the deceleration field generator, I guess that's going to be from the science ship. It's going to give you plus 15 to exotic damage. Plus 15% to exotic damage. What? Wow. Exotic damage, that is awesome. This is basically, wow, that's a lot. 15%. Crazy amount. Anyway, One thing that I did not showcase was the bridge officer station and seating. So we have a lieutenant commander universal station, so you can put engineering up here, tactical or science, all up to you. We have a commander tactical temporal ops station, so you know, you can put, I'm gonna put you up here, just why not. No, I'm not gonna put you, I'm gonna put you up here, Catan. And also a lieutenant engineering command station. Do I have a command station? Yeah, let's put you, but I don't want to do those. Do I have anybody else? No. Well, let's put you up there then. And a lieutenant commander science station with science abilities. Let's use a gravity well. Definitely want to upgrade this thing. Gravity well one. Maybe a food bag pulse is better. And an ensign science station. Now, I do want to say one thing. Don't use this bridge officer layout. This is just something that I am making up as I go. Just to have a couple of abilities. So I'm not going to be killed real fast. No thought has gone into this build as of now. So make sure you understand what I mean right there. Also, let's go to the Starship bridge. Now, there is a unique bridge on this thing, as we showcased when we're going, when we were going to through the customization. So we are what? This is like a inner sphere. Or I mean, it's not like an inner sphere, it is an inner sphere. Wow. Wow, even you have like even current going through that thing. Wow, this looks amazing. Wow. Definitely love these new pillars that they're putting up. Love that. Okay, so this is I don't know if you guys have seen this one in Jonathan Archer's episode when he actually entered the spheres. This is kind of looking like that. Unfortunately, you cannot jump out of this thing. Unfortunately. Unfortunately. Did I really say that? I want to kill myself. Okay, so we got a couple of consoles up here that are not working. These are just here for the visuals. We do have a really unique hologram up here. And this is going to be the other ship that I'm going to do a review about, so stay tuned for that. Maybe tomorrow it's going to come up. So if you want to see that one as well, it's going to be showcased in this channel as well. What is up here? So we got small craft and a couple of consoles that are kind of useless. And we have a sphere of some sort. We cannot access these consoles, so I guess these are the consoles to controlling the sphere, what the sphere is going to do. Nice. A really big view screen. I wish I had that in my room. So I can play Star Trek Online the whole time with you guys and do live streams, videos on that really big screen. Nice. We do have two new consoles up here. So account band, library files, and duty officers are all up at one point. And this is basically where we came in. When we beamed in, we came through here. Wow, this bridge is totally different from all of the other bridges that we've seen. And I definitely love these animations up here that are pulsating this sphere. Oh, that is just awesome. That is definitely awesome. All right, let's take this baby out for a spin. I'll leave the ship interior. Let's take this ship into space combat. And to do that, we're going to do a patrol mission. I'm going to head off to the Argala patrol. Delta, there we go. Kind of need to get used to the option that they give you when you're actually selecting the location of your transwarp. Because these days you can actually have multiple options. Wasn't there before, but it's really awesome because they're really doing us a really big favor. I don't want to assist the Okampa freighter. I want to use my pets in combat. And also, guys, don't forget there is a promotion thingamajab here that is going to give you a large XP boost, 3 Gamma Duty Officer pack, and 1 reward pack. I already got mine. These things, grab them because they're definitely free. As of the time of this recording, obviously. So here we go. Patrol the Argala system with this new awesome sphere builder dreadnought carrier. Now this is definitely a tactical carrier while the mission wanted is going to start. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to utilize my my pets a little bit to actually kill these guys. I definitely don't like that there are really big cooldown times on these guys. But anyway, here we go. Let's go full impulse and let's start firing on this guy. Now the visuals that you guys are seeing, this sphere that is going through, that is just part of the Riemann space set. That's not part of the ship. And let me put these guys on auto fire so they're going to fire continuously. On my enemy. There we go. So we can actually see where the nodes are from the weapons. There is one up there. On this sphere, there are a couple of ones. On the sides of this ship. Let me remove the HUD so you guys see. Nice. Okay, so those were the nodes. There are like up here and in the sphere. In the dome. Alright. So, let me put these guys to attack my target. Wow, look at that. Molecular deconstruction beam, look at that. They're using that right there. Wow, killed that guy in a hurry. What? Oh man, I love these things. Now, my molecular deconstruction beam wasn't actually up there, but theirs was. They were actually using that. That is amazing. That is cool. Okay, so these guys are next. Do I have gravity well? No, I had feedback pulse. Okay. Let's utilize these unique... not the unique, the universal console that came off with this what is it called? The Chroniton Fragmentation Warhead Launcher. Somewhere where I can... Let's use it on this guy. In 3, 2, 1. Boom. Okay, here goes. It's going. Boom! It exploded. Wow, it took this guy out, but my pets are doing an enormous amount of damage. I'm going to recall them because they're going through the enemy real quick. That's not good. Now, I do have a couple of buffs and a couple of traits that are helping me as it is right now, but... Wow, these pets of mine that are doing so much damage. Look at that. Oh, my shield system is offline. Anyway, let's target this guy and use our weapons a little bit while we sit up here for the cooldown of these guys. Beam fire wheel. And we're going to use beam fired wheel only one single target for real. Anyway, it's all good. It's all good. Wow, these guys are killing these Kazon Raiders in a hurry, man. Wow. Here we go, in a couple of seconds, 10 seconds, and we're going to fire that thing again. Now, it doesn't really turn real quick. It is a carrier after all. Keep that in mind. But definitely with these bridge officer abilities, you have a commander tactical or temporal ops station up here. You have a command station and also a universal lieutenant commander universal station, so you can basically go all the way that you want. Here we go, in 3, 2, 1, let's fire this thing again. It's going, it hit this thing. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, kinetic explosion, there it goes. What is offline? Something went offline. Wow. It's using evasive maneuvers, it's not being able to do that. That is just crazy. Whoa, my shields are gone. Shields. There we go. Wow, that was definitely awesome. Really excited that I actually made this purchase on this thing. This thing looks really amazing. Let's take it out of combat. Before I'm going to die. God damn it. Don't I have any whole healing abilities? No. Okay. Here we go. It's a little bit damaged. It's a little bit torn up. Wow, this is definitely an awesome ship to fly. I definitely love these pets with their abilities up here that you guys can actually see. Can we go into information? There we go. So advanced fuel, so you have beam overload 2, torpedo high yield, and channel deconstruction 1. These abilities are definitely awesome to have, and I definitely recommend you guys actually spending a little bit of dilithium, spending a little bit of your fleet credits to actually obtain these guys, because they are amazing. As you guys just witnessed, they were actually killing the enemy faster than I was doing with my noob build. But anyway, I hope you guys have enjoyed this visual video of this thing. What's it called again? The Sphere Builders Denuos Dreadnought Carrier, and that is a tier 6 ship. And this thing has definitely been amazing review to do. Hope to see you on the next one, where I'm going to do the other video for the other ship from the Sphere Builders Lockbox. For now, I'm just going to say take care, and maybe, hopefully, I'm going to see you when I'm going to do the Lockbox giveaway. No, not the Lockbox giveaway, but when I'm going to do the giveaway on Saturday. It's going to be really awesome, because I have lots of items that players are actually giving me. Like, these guys are still... What? Saturday giveaway. Chucky Love right now gave me an incomplete Aegis space set, including a couple of upgrades. These things are going to be given away. Tellarites. These entire... weapons set, 5 weapons going to be given away, lots of items. I hope to see you there as well. Anyway, take care for now, and hope to see you on the next one. Later.